إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، I welcome all of you, and what we're going to do tonight, insha'Allah ta'ala, is to bring a reminder of a topic that is familiar to all of us, but because of its importance, and especially in these days, these blessed days and the virtuous days of the Hijjah, we want to bring it once again as a reminder for myself first and for my brothers and sisters in Islam, the excellence of the dhikr Allah. The excellence of the remembrance of Allah and the importance of the remembrance of Allah in the lives of the Muslim. قال الشيخ الوالد العلامة صالح الفوزان بن فوزان حفظه الله تعالى اتقوا الله تعالى واعلموا أن الله أمركم أن تذكروه ذكرا كثيرا وتسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا لأن ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى تطمئن به القلوب كما قال تعالى في سورة الرعد الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب. أو نوب الشيخ العلامة الدكتور الوالد صالح الفوزان حفظه الله تعالى ومتعه بالصحة والعافية وغفر له ولوالديه وللمسلمين والمسلمات آمين. After reminding us, because this is actually was a khutbah by the Sheikh and we use it as a class, alhamdulillah. But people, they benefited from him as a khutbah. So he, as usual, in the khutbah, advised the people to fear Allah, which it means to act upon the commands of Allah to the best of one's ability and to stay away from the prohibitions as legislated to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, and then he says, you should know that Allah has ordered you to mention his name, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to remember him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, a lot, and to glorify him in the morning and in the evening. That is because one of the great fruits of the remembrance of Allah is that it brings ease and tranquility to the hearts. Ayna, subhanAllah. That's a great fruit of remembrance of Allah. You bring that ease, that serenity, that tranquility, that peace of mind, ease in the heart. You can't buy with money or with status. This is how it is. Free, alhamdulillah. Remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he mentioned the ayah 28 of Surah Al-Ra'd, and that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and the meaning of what Allah says in English, and those who believe and their hearts feel at ease with the remembrance of Allah. For indeed, with the remembrance of Allah, do hearts feel at ease. Allahu Akbar. So this is the first benefit. This is the first thing you highlight. Taking a note, this is the first one. We as a human being, we always look for ease, for peace, tranquility, serenity, peace of mind. This is how we find it. We're not going to find it in moving from a place to a bigger place. Sometimes bigger places come with bigger problems. But here is how tranquility, serenity, peace, it comes easy, alhamdulillah, by remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَخْبَرَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَىٰ أَنَّ الْإِكْثَارَ مِنْ ذِكْرِهِ سَبَبٌ لِلْفَلَاحِ. أخبر سبحانه وتعالى أن الإكثار من ذكره سبب للفلاح. قال تعالى في سورة الأنفال واذكروا الله كثيرا لعلكم تفلحون. The Sheikh حفظه الله تعالى says Allah also informed us that remembering him a lot, mentioning his name and glorifying him subhanahu wa ta'ala and praising him and the like from all of the other forms of the remembrance of Allah, as we're going to learn later on, he said this one of the means that lead to success. Allahu Akbar. Everybody wants to be successful. in this life, even the little things you do, you want to be successful at it. Nobody wants to be a loser. Nobody. Even the children, our children, they play a game, innocent game, still they don't want to lose. Now you want to be amongst the winners, the successful. This is one of the things. The remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah says, وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ Al-Anfal 45. And remember Allah much. Because that's what makes you successful. كما أخبر سبحانه أن الذي يلهيه ماله وولده عن ذكر الله يكون خاسرا في الدنيا والآخرة والعياذ بالله. أي نعم الذي يلهيه ماله وولده عن ذكر الله مشغول بالدنيا مسكين الصلاة يا أخي لا ما أخي عندي كيف الصلاة أترك العمل أجل الصلاة لا عنده سبع محلات وخمس ما أدري إيش مشغول بالدنيا مسكين ما يذكر الله ولا يقرأ قرآن ولا يقول سبحان الله مشغول بالأموال وبالنقود وبالزبائن وبالبضائع وبالأولاد الله أخبرنا عن هذا هذا يكون خاسرا والعياذ بالله في الدنيا والآخرة. Likewise, the Sheikh says, Allah informed us that as for the one who his wealth and his children, they take him away from the remembrance of Allah. Because some people, they like that. Come for Salat. Salat? No, he has three stores. What is time for Salat? From one store to another, from one business to another, running all over the place. Miskeen, before Fajr, he's up in the markets. Hey, subhanAllah, forget about Allah, forget about the hereafter, liyadu billah. This person, even though they, as the Shaykh is going to mention later on, when it looks to the people, they're successful, because they got a lot of money, business, this, oh, that's a successful man. But with Allah, if this person, that wealth, that money, those children, took him away from the remembrance of Allah, he's a loser. In both this life and the hereafter. Even though people look at him and say, man, that's a successful brother right there. No, he's not. The successful one is the one who remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon obedience to Allah. And he mentioned the ayah in Surah Al-Munafiqun. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُلْهِكُمْ أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُكُمْ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ O you who believe, let not your wealth nor your children divert you away from the remembrance of Allah. It's not haram to have children, it's halal. It's not haram to be a businessman or to be successful in your money and be rich. That's not it's not forbidden in the deen. It's okay as long as you do it in the right way from means that are halal, and it should not take you away from the remembrance of Allah. Should not take you away from Salat, should not take you away from Quran, should not take you away from Istighfar, should not take you away from Tasbih and the like. Performing the prayers that the Shaykh is going to mention later on. O you who believe, let not your wealth, subhanAllah, this is from Allah. This is not somebody like a man advising a man, Akhi, look man, lately when you've been having, you're making money, but watch out, we don't see you in the masjid, oh no. No, this is a statement of Allah, ya akhi. You're not going to say, who are you to talk to me? This is Allah, alladhi khalaqaka, ya Abdullah. The one who created us. He says, let not your wealth, nor your children take you away and divert you away from the remembrance of Allah. Allahu Akbar. And Allah says, وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ But he who does this now, meaning that he's been taken away from the remembrance of Allah, been busy with his dunya, the dunya settled in his heart, on her heart. The children, from a training to another training, from a practice to another practice, from an appointment to another appointment. Baseball practice at 9:30, and a soccer practice at 11:15. Tennis, I don't know what, orientation at 1:16. What is the dhuhr time? What is salat al-duha? What is qira'at al-Quran? What is the remembrance of Allah? Oh, I got to do this for my children. What are you doing for yourself? And these children, that's all you do for them? What is the hissas? What is Arabic in all this program? Baseball, soccer, I don't know, tennis, swimming, horse riding, kayaking. But what is the Quran, the Arabic, the Tawheed, the Aqidah? Where is it in this schedule? That's what's going to help these children to be a better servants of Allah. Naam. Balance, ya akhwan. Ay naam. And we will have to make priorities. We have to choose that which is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That which is going to help us in Yawm al-Qiyamah when we stand in front of Allah. ستموت وحدك يا عبد الله وستوضع في القبر وحدك وتقف أمام الله وحدك. أي نعم. You're gonna die alone. And they're gonna put you in a grave alone. Ain't nobody gonna die with you. And yet you're gonna stand in front of Allah for accounting alone. No lawyers, nothing. No money, no helpers, no friends. فأعد للسؤال جوابا صوابا. And you're gonna be asked. We are gonna be questioned and asked. So we will rather prepare some serious answers while we can. Aynam. So Allah says, but if a person's wealth and children take them away from the remembrance of Allah, such are those who are losers. Allahu Akbar. Allah said that. These are the losers. فحكم عليهم يقول الشيخ الفوزان فحكم عليهم الله سبحانه وتعالى هو الذي حكم فحكم عليهم بالخسران مع أنهم يظنون أنهم قد ربحوا الأموال والأولاد. الله أكبر. This is the ruling of Allah on such people, that they are losers even though they have money, have children, have wealth. To some other they're like, no, he's successful. How do you do it, brother? How can I get your money? I do it. No salat on time. No Quran for I don't know how, who knows. Neglecting the rights of Allah, the rights of the wife, the rights of the children. They don't even see him. You want to be like that? That's success? No, that's not what success. Success is the remembrance of Allah. Is being upon obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وذكر الله تعالى يجمع للعبد خيري الدنيا والآخرة ويعينه على مشاق الحياة وعلى تحصيل الطاعات. Here is some of the benefits and the fruits. What the remembrance of Allah do for us, because we're human being. Anything you want to do is like, what is it for me, right? What is going to help me? What can I get out of it, right? That's, we always ask these questions. Okay, here is what the remembrance of Allah, the Shaykh says. Says the remembrance of Allah bring to you, ya Abdullah, both the good in this life and the good in the hereafter. Allahu Akbar. All good in this life and all the good that you will get it in the hereafter is from the remembrance of Allah. Dhikrullah. Likewise, the remembrance of Allah help you to go through the difficulties of this time, of this life. You're not in Jannah, you're in dunya. And you should know about the dunya by now. You've been in it for a while. You get sick and you get trouble, people looking at you funny, people want to cheat you, deception, you receive bad emails, a lot of things. You go through a lot of hardships. So the remembrance of Allah gets you through. Allahu Akbar. And also it helps you to obey Allah in an easy way. Because some of us, we have difficulties, man. We pray and fast, but it's difficult. It's a burden. No, some people, they love to do it, man. They love to pray and fast and give sadaqah and read Quran. And they love to come early to masjid and spend more time in it and do good and forgive and pardon and forbear. Allahu Akbar, na'am. What is how? The remembrance of Allah. The remembrance of Allah will help us that the ta'at become easy for us. فَقَدْ أَتَى إِلَى النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ رَجُلٌ فَاعِلٌ فَقَالَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ إِنَّ شَرَائِعَ الْإِسْلَامِ قَدْ كَثُرَتْ عَلَيَّ فَبَابٌ نَتَمَسَّكُ بِهِ جَامِعٌ. A man came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and said, Allahu Akbar. O Messenger of Allah, there is many fields and signs of this Islam. As you know, there is fiqh, hadith, aqidah, tawheed, usul, bas, this, Arabic. He says that there are many for this man. He said, there are too many for me to handle.
advise me with something that will help me, something that is good in it for me if I do.
Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to him, لا يزال لسانك رطبا من ذكر الله. Allah Akbar. He said, let your tongue moist with the remembrance of Allah. Some people, they keep their tongue moist with the backbiting. Aina, constantly eating the flesh of others. They need to change their diets. That's a bad diet. Eating the flesh of others. Aina, Rabbi, you want your tongue moist? Keep your tongue moist with the remembrance of Allah. Meaning, remember Allah a lot.
قال والإكثار من هذا الحديث رواه الإمام أحمد رحمه الله قال الشيخ صالح حفظه الله والإكثار من ذكر الله براءة من النفاق لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه وصف المنافقين بأنهم لا يذكرون الله إلا قليلا الله أكبر. Another great benefit of the remembrance of Allah, those who remember Allah much all time, the freedom from hypocrisy. Allahu Akbar. Why? He said, because Allah has described the hypocrites from their characteristics that they don't remember Allah except for a few moments. If they do. Subhanallah.
But the believer, he don't want this khisla of the munafiqeen, this characteristic of the munafiqeen, of the hypocrites. La, he remembers Allah all time.
قال بعض السلف علامة حب الله كثرة ذكره.
Said one of the Salaf says, the people that we follow their example, the pious predecessors, he says one of the signs that a person truly love Allah, that person remember Allah much. I know, that's a sign. Find out. You don't need somebody to praise you on WhatsApp. Now when you're praised by on some group, oh, mashallah, la, ya akhi, hubbullah is the real sign for it. You don't need somebody to send you a text message that, oh, akhi, you love Allah. I know that. I've been watching you. Ain't going to help you. You need to find out yourself how? Remembrance of Allah.
قال فإنك لن تحب شيئا إلا أكثرت من ذكره.
Allahu Akbar.
He said, whenever you love a thing,
except you're going to mention it a lot. Those who love someone, man, it's always on their mind. It's always on their tongue. They run through their minds. They run through their minds all the time. It's always on their minds. They love them. They mention them always with good qualities. Now, person love Allah but don't remember Allah, don't mention Allah, nothing. What, this is love? نعم.
وقد ذكرت عائشة رضي الله عنها أم المؤمنين أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يذكر الله على كل أحيانه. تعني ماذا؟ قال الشيخ تعني في حال قيامه ومشيه وقعوده واضطجاعه.
الله أكبر. Our mother Aisha radiallahu anha, because the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they are the mothers of the believers. Aynam bi nass al-Quran, by the text from the Quran. So she said, what she said to us about the remembrance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his dhikr of Allah. Qalat, he used to remember Allah on all of his all situations. Ahsant.
نعم. But she the Sheikh, he explained what it means, all situations. He said, meaning
while he's standing. If the Prophet is standing, he remembers Allah. Do we stand or not? Those amongst us are able to stand. Do you stand sometimes? What do you stand for? Salat. نعم, that's remembrance of Allah. Outside the Salat, you stand? I see you standing a lot. And perhaps you saw me too. You stand for work. Some people, they stand 4 hours before they get a break. You stand waiting for what? The bus.
You stand doing what? Ahsan. Washing dishes, even if you're married. Oh, yeah, right. Correct me if I'm wrong, man. I don't know what I'm thinking about. Husband married and wash the dishes? No, it's not. Is it? Is it the case? Why are you looking at me like speaking Korean now, Chinese, and you don't understand Chinese or what? Yeah, yes, you do the dishes, why not? Sometimes. You run the vacuum, you rotate the laundry, you cook if you know how to cook, why not? Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to wash his own clothes. He used to sew his and fix his own clothes. He used to وَكَانَ فِي مَاذَا مُؤْنَةِ أَهْلِهِ. He used to help around in the house. Who is he? Who is the one we're talking about now? Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Somebody said, no, I got a job. I've done my job. I went to work. Where's the food? Sit like he's there. I don't know what. La ya akhi. You think you're busy? The Prophet ﷺ has the biggest responsibilities. He was sent to all mankind, the jinn and the human being. Everybody wants to talk to him. Everybody wants to ask him a question. And he's thinking like, oh man, when somebody says, I want to talk to you, and you get messed up, like, what do you want to talk about, man? Don't have no time. And you think that's it, because somebody talked to you for 10 minutes, now you're going to go home and say, hey, nobody talked to me, I'm not going to do anything. The Prophet ﷺ busy, this one, asking him a question, he's teaching, giving da'wah, being patient, giving this, talking to that. Allahu Akbar. Then he go home, Allahu Akbar. He's kind, easy to his wives. I know. Some man, he think like if his wife say, hey, help me with the dishes, he think like he's gonna like tarnish his manhood or something. I'm going to do it, but you don't tell nobody. What are you afraid of? Yeah, do it. This is good. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. You have indeed in the Messenger of Allah the best example. Wallahi, that lady, your wife or my wife, you run the vacuum or you do the dishes, she's going to be very happy. Right? And that's the end of it. That's it. Take notes. All right? She's going to be very happy. She's going to appreciate. All right? Allahu Akbar. She's going to appreciate that. Ay na'am barakallahu feekum. Hayyakallah. Zakallah khair. Tayyib. So Aisha said, the Prophet ﷺ, he used to remember Allah while he's standing, while he's walking. Now you're walking, remember Allah. Make it easy for you. You can walk for miles. You don't even notice that you do miles. Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illa, astaghfirullah. Allahu Akbar, Allahumma salli wa sallim ala nabiyyina Muhammad. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Subhanallah, la ilaha illa, Allahu Akbar. And you're rolling, you're going. And you don't even notice, you don't even feel that. Not like somebody who just like, where is it? And remember Allah. It's going to make it easy. وَقُعُودِهِ. While you're sitting, you remember Allah. You're waiting, you're in this, you're in a bus ride, what you do? Don't worry about who's getting, who got out, who's passing, who the light is turning green. You're not driving the bus. Remember Allah. You have Quran, read the Quran. You have an MP3, listen to Sheikh Rabia, Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi, Sheikh Ubaid, Sheikh Fawzan, Sheikh bin Baz, the Mashayikh of Ahlul Sunnah. That's what you do. You don't have that, you run out of battery, what do you do now? The dhikrullah, bismillah, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illa, Allahu Akbar, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh, Allahumma anta rabbi la ilaha illa anta khalaqtanuna abduk, to the end of the hadith, ayatul kursi, review your word of the Quran, that surah you're working on, mashallah, take advantage. Now you have some time. You went to a dentist appointment, doctor appointment, whatever appointment, and they tell you, okay, sign here, you sign, and it's like, we'll call your name. Say, okay, sit down. Allah just give you some 10 minutes, 15, 20, 30 more to do what? To remember Allah. اقضوا أوقات الانتظار بالاستغفار كما يقولون. Don't get mad and look at them when they call somebody. Why you call him before me? I was here before him. None of your business. Let them do what they do. Do what you're doing. As one of the Salaf from Tabi'in, I forget his name. I don't know. Maybe it's Sa'id ibn Musayyib, if I'm not mistaken. He went to the barber, get a haircut. And then the barber get to the point he's going to trim his mustache. And this Salaf, this Alim, he's remembering Allah. So the barber, he want to do, he's like, can you just stay still? He said, I'm still. He says, no, I mean your lips. He said, what about me? Can you just stop? And he said, do your things, I'm doing my things. Do what you got to do. I have to do what I got to do, remembering Allah. Subhanallah. Look at this. Ayna. Because when you remember Allah, you don't even know what's going on around you. You're remembering Allah. You go home, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. Smile, the wife, hayyak, kayfa haluk al-yawm? How was your day? Everything is okay? Ash, ayna al-awlad? Kayf halukum? Kayf salam? Huh? And then you go and remember Allah. What's going to happen after that? She already burned the food and she's afraid. And she cook another one. You don't even notice. Right or wrong? Why? You're remembering Allah. Your mind is not in the kitchen. Your mind in the akhirah. She already burned it or she missed it up or she dropped that plate, the first plate. You even notice. Not like somebody said there looking at the kitchen. Watch out, you're gonna drop it. I told you. You don't listen. Fight. Break up. No, he's remembering Allah. He don't care what she's doing in the kitchen. But that's the problem. You find some of us, his eyes in the kitchen, his wife, what you doing? What you not doing? What is taking you too long? But when he go to some restaurant, a kafir cooking, you don't care. They come to him, worse. A lady come and say, sir, we do apologize. It's going to take some... Take your time. Yeah, I'm in no rush. Yeah. You see what I'm talking about? Aina. But then if his wife said, honey, nicely, mashallah, I'm taking me some time. It's going to be ready, inshallah, soon. What do you do, Abdullah? What he should do? Yeah, he said, don't worry, take your time. Alhamdulillah, actually, I have to finish this chapter. Jazakallahu khairan. Food is just going to take me away from what I'm doing. Akhi, if we bring you some qisas from the Salaf, akhi, they said some of the Salaf, they don't eat the food we eat. They don't. Yes. You see the food, me and you, we sit down, rice and chew and all these potatoes and meat and bread. They like, lad, this food takes a long time to eat. They drink beverages, soups, easy. He's done. Lunch is over. Now you go back to the remembrance of Allah, to writing, to studying. So much so that one of the Salaf, he says, while he was doing and writing, his daughter or his sister, she will feed him. She will try to put something in his mouth. See, now we hear these things and we're like, nah, come on, man. That's impossible. Because of our life is not like their life. See, that's their life. So now when me, or maybe you, brother, don't know, I can speak only for myself, when I read things like this, I'm like, come on. How is this? Somebody that don't even have 45 minutes for a good meal. 45 minutes. Akhi, you tell somebody, you tell this to Ali ibn al-Madini. Huh? Or Abu Hatim al-Razi, tell him some people, if they know some people, they spend 45 minutes eating lunch. They're like, what lunch is this? 45 minutes? Subhanallah, 45 minutes, you can read the whole book. 45 minutes, you can write 30 hadith. But this is who we are. And may Allah make us better. Ameen. Now. ما الذي جرنا إلى هذا الكلام؟ ما الذي جرنا إلى هذا الكلام؟ What is that which brought us to all of this? Huh? Akram? Abu Darda? أين؟ أي. أي قلنا يعني إذا أين أحسن نعم أبو الدرداء توافقه أنت لا توافق تخالف أنت مخالف لماذا تخالف أخاك هو مسلم يا أخي سبحان الله لماذا تخالفه تفضل أحسن أهله عينا هذا الذي جرنا إليه أحسنت نعم that which brought us to all of this is that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he is to help in the house عينا so we have a good example in the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم we men نعم you worked hard but hey come home and do what you can you don't get it wallahi sometimes the woman she see you just starting she's like oh no don't I got it And you're like, all right, mashallah. Now, alhamdulillah, that's a good thing. Scoring points, you don't even know. Aina, barakallahu feekum. Naam, easy points. Mashallah. What is it? Mashallah. Ayyah Allah. Allah yaj'alhum min as-salihin. قال وقد وصف الله سبحانه أي واضطجاعه Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم also قعوده واضطجاعه Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم she said he used to remember Allah while standing while walking while sitting while laying even when he lay down he remembered Allah Allahu Akbar Allahu Akbar and that's all the thing you be doing whether you're standing whether you're walking whether you're laying down or whether you're sitting أين وقد وصف الله المؤمنين بذلك فقال الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم Allah described the believers as such he says they are from their characteristics and their qualities of the believers that they remember Allah while standing and sitting and on their sides laying on their sides so whenever you stand in doing anything subhanallah alhamdulillah la ilaha illallah You got a phone call now? Cut the remembrance. Answer the phone call. I said, keep it to the point. Assalamu alaikum. Subhanallah. Alhamdulillah. La ilaha. You're walking? Same thing. Astaghfirullah. 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 La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. You pass by somebody, give you salam, will you give him salam? Naam. Assalamu alaikum. Alaykum salam. Hayyakallah. Naam. Somebody ask you, Akhi, where is Walmart? I'm lost. Hey, Walmart is behind you. Actually, you passed it. Just go. That's it. You give him direction, and that's it. Go back to Subhanallah. Alhamdulillah. La ilaha illallah. Allahu akbar. Astaghfirullah. You waiting for somebody or somebody waiting on you or you doing some work remembrance of Allah ya. Because if you don't remember Allah if you don't shaitan have a plan for you and we should know the plans of the shaitan قال الشيخ حفظه الله the ayah we just mentioned in Surah Ali Imran ayah 191 وقد فرض الله على المسلمين أن يذكروه كل يوم وليلة خمس مرات بإقامة الصلوات الخمس في مواقيتها المؤقتة وشرع لهم مع هذه الفرائض الخمس أن يذكروه ذكرا يكون لهم نافلة أي زيادة على الفرض. The Sheikh says Allah سبحانه وتعالى has legislated and made an obligation upon the Muslims to remember him five times. In a day and a night, by establishing the prayers now, in their right times. And with that, plus these five obligatory prayers in a day and a night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has legislated for us separatory acts of prayers. Allahu Akbar, extra for us to remember Him more. وَهُوَ نَوْعَانَ And this separatory of prayers, there's two types. أحدهما من جنس الصلاة حيث شرع لهم أن يصلوا مع الصلوات الخمس قبلها أو بعدها سننا تكون زيادة على صلاة الفريضة The first of these two types is that which is from the salat related to the salat itself the obligatory salat since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has legislated for his servants to perform some supererogatory acts of prayers before or after this
or some of these obligatory prayers. Sunan. Now you pray your obligatory like Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, but then there is other prayers. Sunnah Ratiba. That is wait before or after, or sometimes it could be for some salawat is before and after. Immediately before and immediately after that obligatory prayer. فَإِنْ كَانَ فِي الْفَرِيدِ. Now Sheikh gives us the reason. What is the benefits of this sunnah? So we can know. It's not like pray the sunnah. No, I'm not praying the sunnah. You go pray. No, it's not obligatory. It's obligatory? No, it's not obligatory. Akhi, you pray. I'm not praying. No. لا هي السنة الراتبة. If a person is gonna go home after the Salat of Dhuhr, for example, he go and pray. He prayed better in his home. For so many texts we have, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he says, لا تجعلوا بيوتكم مقابر. Do not make and render your homes as graveyards. صلوا فيها. فإن أحسن صلاة الرجل في بيته. إلا المكتوبة. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, do not make your graveyards, addressing the men, your homes as a graveyard, pray in them. For indeed, the best prayer of a man is in his home, except the obligatory prayer. So if a person lives close to the masjid and he's going to go straight to his house, it's better for him to pray that sunnah at home. But if a person is going to go after masjid, he's going to work or going to shop or somewhere else, he pray in the masjid. Okay? Likewise, if a person live close to the masjid, once the adhan is in, for Salat al-Fajr, for example, he'll pray at home. And he will come to the masjid and pray with the jama'ah. But if he live far, and by the time if he pray the sunnah in his home, come here, miss the Salat, he come early and pray it in the masjid, inshallah. Mafhum? Nah. جزاك الله خير. قال فإن كان في الفريضة نقص جبر بهذه النوافل. الله أكبر. وإلا كانت النوافل زيادة على الفرائض. The Sheikh says now if that obligatory prayer or the Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib and Isha for instance is deficient, and who amongst us can be sure, as Sheikh Al-Albani said that in one of his tapes, the Sheikh Al-Albani says, and who is that person amongst us is sure 100% that his salat, every salat he prayed, is no deficiency whatsoever, they all complete. He said, look, if that obligatory prayer has deficiency, then it will be made out from the nawafil. And Sheikh Al-Albani said it, he says, if a person now is praying alhamdulillah the nawafil, the sunan, alhamdulillah, on Yawm al-Qiyamah, they will make up for his deficiencies. He said, can you imagine someone this dunya is constantly is he wajib? Nah, I'm not praying. Nah, wajib, not praying. On Yawm al-Qiyamah, he don't even have turaqat to make up for his deficiencies. Subhanallah. Aynam, we should make ijtihad and inshallah, نجتهد. مش اجتهاد like فقهاء. نجتهد. We should be diligent and serious in trying to perform these prayers and المحافظة عليها, to preserve them and to remind one another nicely, kindly. Not like, hey, you didn't pray, man. No. Nicely. بأدب. حسن أدب. Remind your brother, mashallah, pray the sunnah and this and that, alhamdulillah. Find the best way, okay, to approach. Because people are not all on the same level. Some people, they can't take anything from you. Just throw it at them. Some people know, man, you have to be very smooth with them and easy because that's who they are. So what do you want? You need to know your people. Huh? I know. Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, he says one of the characteristics and the qualities of a successful da'i, a caller, is that he يعرف حالة المدعوين. He need to know the conditions of the people he's dealing with. He don't just talk to this one in the same way. Some people, mashallah, you talk to them. Some people, they get offended. They like this. Nothing. So you have to know how
as the purpose is that the people they alhamdulillah they get the point, but you deliver it alhamdulillah in a way that is beneficial for everybody. Now, دين الشيخ يقبل some benefit. قال لما كان بين صلاة العشاء وصلاة الفجر وبين صلاة الفجر وصلاة الظهر وقت طويل ليس فيه صلاة مفروضة شرع بين شرع بين العشاء وصلاة الفجر صلاة الوتر وقيام الليل وشرع بين صلاة الفجر وصلاة الظهر صلاة الضحى. The Sheikh says since now between the Isha prayer and Fajr prayer is there is no obligatory prayer, like it's a long time between these two obligatory prayers. Likewise, between Fajr and Dhuhr, there is a longer time. It's not like the time between Dhuhr and Asr, or Asr, Maghrib, Maghrib and Isha. He said for this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has legislated for the people after Isha to pray witr in this long time, to pray the night prayer with witr. And also, that long time between Fajr and Dhuhr, people, they pray Salat al-Duha. Naam. ثم قال الشيخ وشرع لهم سبحانه وتعالى أي لعباده أن يذكروه باللسان بالتهليل والتكبير والتسبيح والتحميد في جميع الأوقات ويتأكد عقيب الصلوات أي بعد الصلوات المفروضات بالأذكار الواردة عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بعد السلام يعني تسليم من الصلاة بعد الانتهاء من الصلاة. The Sheikh says, "Naam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has legislated for them, for His servants, to remember Him with their tongue. With tahleel, by saying, La ilaha illallah, by saying, Allahu Akbar, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, in all of the times. In all times. Especially, Naam, you preserve the remembrance of Allah after each obligatory prayer. By saying that which the Prophet ﷺ used to say. Aina. You learn what the Prophet ﷺ used to say after he finished the salat, and that's what you say. And how he used to say it. He used to say it by himself, silently, or he used to raise his voice sometimes. He used to raise his hand and not raise his hand. He used to kiss his hands, like some people kiss their hands. People kiss their hands. They pass their hands on their heads 3 times. They pass them on their chest 3 times. They raise their hands again. Some people, they all, the imam, after every salat, they all, Allahumma kada wa kada. And together they tell everybody, yalla, 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 bismillah, bismillah. Now we say, is the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did that? Did he do that? If they say yes, we say, hatu burhanakum. هاتوا الدليل الحمد لله we want to do what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to do, but if they don't have no دليل and they won't, because he's the ulama before for all these centuries, they couldn't find one hadith that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to make collective dua after the salat. Rather is from the bid'ah al-muhdatha, so we leave it alone, we don't do it. قال ويتأكد أيضا ذكر الله باللسان بعد الصلاتين اللتين لا تطوع بعدهما وهما الفجر والعصر. نعم سبحان الله يا أخواني. We need the علماء. Says likewise, there is an emphasis on the remembrance of Allah with the tongue after those two prayers, that there is no nafil prayer after them. What are they? Fajr and Asr. He says, now you make the remembrance of Allah longer. Aina, subhanAllah. Because there is no nafil. You're not going to pray after Fajr. You're not going to pray after Asr. Now there is what is legislated for us, remembrance of Allah longer. فَيُشْرَعُ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ صَلَاتِ الْفَجْرِ إِلَىٰ أَنْ تَطْلُعَ الشَّمْسِ. Naam, it is legislated for you to stay there after Fajr if you want to. It's not an obligation. And remember Allah until sunrise. Allahu Akbar. Until sunrise. وبعد صلاة العصر حتى تغرب الشمس. Likewise, yes, you can sit after Asr is over, you can sit in your spot. You can sit and stay in the masjid until, and remember Allah until Maghrib. Of course, if you have things to go and take care of, go take care of.
person is taking a break from his work, he came and pray Asr. Oh, Abu Muhammad says, that's not what Muhammad says. You go to work. Don't get yourself fired. No, you go to work. Or if you have your mother waiting for you after Asr, you go and take care of that. And you can remember Allah while you're driving, while you're walking, while you... Aynam. But for the people that have time, what to do? Stay, akhi, and remember Allah. Can you imagine if somebody's the death come upon him? What he's going to be doing? Huh? Is he going to go somewhere, do something else? Wallahi, akhi, we're negligent. And we hope, we ask Allah to help us and to benefit us with this. Aynam. قال وهذان الوقتان هما أفضل أوقات النهار للذكر. He said these two times they are the best times of the day for the remembrance of Allah. After Fajr and after Asr. These are the best times for the remembrance of Allah, for ذكر الله. وقد أمر الله بذكره فيهما في آيات كثيرة. That's why you find Allah سبحانه وتعالى has ordered that he be remembered and his name to be mentioned and glorified in many آيات. وسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا. نعم, glorify him سبحانه وتعالى early in the day and in the afternoons. Mean after Fajr and after Asr. Surah Al-Ahzab verse 42. Also I mentioned the ayah 41 in Surah Al-Imran. وسبح بالعشي والإبكار. نعم. And glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before evening and early, the early part of the day. And also in Surah Al-A'raf, verse 205, قال تعالى, وَذْكُرْ رَبَّكَ فِي نَفْسِكَ تَضَرُّعًا وَخِيفَةً وَدُونَ الْجَهْرِ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ بِالْغُدُوِّ وَالْآثَارِ وَلَا تَكُنْ مِنَ الْغَافِلِينَ وَلَا تَكُنْ مِنَ الْغَافِلِينَ. We say that's the A'raf, right? What ayah? 205. The ayah before the last. And remember your Lord within yourself, humbly, meaning while humbling yourself, and with fear and without loudness in words, in the mornings and in the afternoons. And don't be of those who are neglectful, heedless, reckless, and heedless and the like. He mentioned also the ayah 39 Surah Qaf, وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقَبْلَ الْغُرُوبِ. Allahu Akbar. And praise and glorify the praise of your Lord before the sunrise and before the sunset. Allahu Akbar. And also he mentioned the ayah 17 in Surah Ar-Rum, فَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ حِينَ تُمْسُونَ وَحِينَ تُصْبِحُونَ. Glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the evenings and in the mornings. Allahu Akbar. ثم بعد هذين الوقتين يذكر الله في سائر ساعات الليل والنهار بالذكر المطلق ويدخل فيه الصلوات النوافل وتلاوة القرآن وتعلمه وتعليمه وتعليم العلم النافع. Allahu Akbar. ويدخل فيه التسبيح والتكبير والتهليل. Now once these times, right after Fajr and after Asr, the virtue of these times to remember Allah, he said, now, but a person will remember Allah along with that in all of the times, at night and at the day, which include the prayers. The prayers is a form of remembrance of Allah. The obligatory prayers, the supererogatory prayers. Likewise, the recitation of the Qur'an, that's the remembrance of Allah. Learning the Qur'an. Why are you learning and memorizing? That's remember, you're remembering Allah. Why teaching the Qur'an? You're remembering Allah. Why learning knowledge? You're remembering Allah. Why teaching knowledge, beneficial knowledge? You're remembering Allah. Included in it, tasbih, when you say, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illa Allahu Akbar. قال, وَإِذَا أَرَادَ الْمُسْلِمْ أَنْ يَنَامْ فَإِنَّهُ يُسْتَحَبُّ لَهُ أَنْ يَنَامَ عَلَى طَهَارَةٍ. Naam, it is recommended for the Muslim before they lay down and go to sleep to sleep on tahara, on purification. ويأتي بما قدر عليه من الأذكار الواردة عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عند النوم ثم ينام على ذلك.
And then once you lay down, you mention and you say the adhkar, you read the adhkar that the Prophet ﷺ used to say before he goes to sleep. Do what you can and memorize from that what you can and say it before you go to sleep and then go to sleep. وَإِذَا اسْتَيْقَدَ وَتَقَلَّبَ فِي رِفِرَاشِهِ ذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَمَا كُلَّمَا تَقَلَّبْ. SubhanAllah, even when you wake up in the middle of the night, some of us, they wake up in the middle of the night for whatever reason. SubhanAllah, still at that moment you woke up, you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then you go back to sleep. Allahu Akbar. While you're still laying down, it's not time for you to get up. But for whatever reason, you got up, and then you remember Allah, and then go back to sleep. فَفِي صَحِيحِ الْبُخَارِي. And he mentioned the hadith, صحيح البخاري, and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قال, مَنْ تَعَارَّ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ. Anyone who woke up in the middle of the night, he was asleep, and he woke up, and said, لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله ثم قال اللهم اغفر لي. He make this dua and he make this ذكر and then he say اللهم اغفر لي, oh Allah forgive me. أو قال ثم دعا, or he ask Allah, istujiba lahu, Allah answer his supplication. وَإِنْ عَزَمَ فَتَوَدَّ ثُمَّ صَلَّ قُبْلَ صَلَاتُهُ. But if a person woke up in the middle of the night and he has that zeal and got up and make wudu and pray, that salat is accepted. أَيْنَا قَالَ مَنْ تَعَارَّ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَقَالَ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله ثم قال اللهم اغفر لي. And then after he make this dhikr, he says, oh Allah, forgive me. SubhanAllah, look at the believer, constantly connected to the remembrance of Allah. You don't wake up and start a fight. Oh, you took my, you're on my side. Oh yeah, you took my pillow. He's going to wake up his wife in the middle of the night, fight over a pillow. Instead of saying the dhikr, and say, oh Allah, forgive me. Huh? No, he's going to wake up. Wake up, get up, move over to your side. Oh, you have by the inches now? Yeah, subhanAllah. No, he get up, he remembers Allah. That's what he knows. That's the Muslim, the believer. He woke up in the middle of the night, and he said what the Prophet said. He said, La ilaha illallah, tawheed. He got up, maybe. Who knows? He say, La ilaha illallah, the angel of death take his soul. He died upon Tawheed, Allahu Akbar. Not die fighting over a pillow. Yes, Allah. Tawheed, ya akhi. You get up, you're upon the Tawheed. You're upon the dhikr of Allah. You're upon good in this life and in the hereafter. Now. You got it? Ayyakum Allah. قال ثم إذا استيقظ من نومه وانتهى منه. Now if a person, now he, alhamdulillah, he sleep, the alarm is on, somebody wake him up, he finished, now he's about to get up, still يبدأ عمله وتحركه للقيام بذكر الله عز وجل. Still he ain't gonna jump off the window, of the bed actually, not the window, sorry. He gonna jump out of the bed straight to the coffee pot. Nobody can talk to this brother. His wife can talk to him. Nobody can talk to him. Nobody can say nothing until he drinks 2 or 3 cups of coffee. Right? Sunnah. You got up, the first thing what you do, you remember Allah. قد ثبت عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه كان إذا استيقظ من منامه يقول الحمد لله الذي أحياني بعدما أماتني وإليه النشور. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to make this dua. As soon as he wake up, he say الحمد لله. He praise Allah. الذي أحياني, who caused me to live, who gave me life. Because the ulama, they mentioned sleep is a death. موت صغرى. أين وفاة صغرى. أين عم. So you praise Allah that he brought you back to life after he caused me to die, and to him the nushur, the resurrection belonged to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. نعم. ولعلنا نتمم إن شاء الله في الدرس نتمم لكن ذكرونا حتى نتمم إن شاء الله. طيب. So إخوان we have what we benefited from this, we remember Allah all the time. You don't have to go somewhere to remember Allah, climb a mountain, go to Mecca. You remember Allah whenever you are at home, while you're driving, at the market, standing, laying down, sitting, while you're eating, while you're walking, while you're doing whatever. Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illa akbar. Hada wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam taslima kathira.